Hi guys, my name is Mr. Carrillo. You know me as the ELL tutor here at your school, World of View. But what a lot of you don't know is that besides working as a teacher within the Anchor School District, I also teach hip-hop dancing at Underground Dance Company. And as you can see around here, this is our studio. And so today, I'll be teaching you guys some basic grooving movement, and we'll use that and correspond that into a dance that you can use for other dances in the future. Okay, so you're just gonna follow me. I know it's a little different learning from a video because I'm not actually here right now since I'm at South in the morning and then I'll be here at Global View in the afternoon. So this is just for periods 1, 2, and 3, possibly 4, but hopefully I'll be here by then so that I can teach them personally. But let's get started, okay? So the song that we're using is called Let's Groove by Earth, Wind & Fire, and it's a remix, so you can find it online. So the way the movement's gonna work, the way we're gonna start, is we're gonna start quasi left, and in French and dance is corner left. From here, you're using your left hand, it's gonna come to your chest, and the start of the music we're waiting for is three big bass hits. So it's gonna go 1, 2, 3, you're gonna hit on 4, 5, 6. So as I hit those, when I bring my left hand over, I'm popping, which is flexing all my muscles at the same time. Hit, hit, hit. From here, you're gonna go back just to prep for one more time. You're gonna do three quick ones. You're gonna press left, step right, switch, right hand left, switch one more time, hit, and then you're gonna come up to foot. Okay, to go a little faster, it's gonna go 5, 6, 7, hit, bass, 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 tap, 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 float. From here, you're gonna step down, you're gonna throw your arms out, you can hear it on a stand note, you're gonna bring your hands back down. From here, you're gonna mani with it, you're gonna step left foot, sit into the movement, grounded, so then go left. You wanna imagine that there's a string pulling your back. That's how you get that effect to where it's leading. You're gonna step left, right. The last one you're gonna step, you're gonna hip up. And what you guys see is it's called a reverse out of the name. But from here, you go 6, 7, hit, down, throw, down, left, right, hit, come back to center. What that means is when you hit from here on the left side, a lot of your weight's on your left. Imagine that there's a wall and you're just hitting that and then you're coming back to center so you're square with the audience. From here, your left hand is going to reach over to your right side, to your right hip. You're going to put most of your weight again on your left side, the ball. You're going to be on the ball of your right foot. Right hand, you're going to cut with it, okay? You're going to eye this counterclockwise. You can do whatever you want to, but it's going to go here twice, left twice, right once, up, and then back down, okay? So there's a difference of a weight change when you do either side. You're gonna go left, 1, 2, right side, 3, 4. And when I say right side, I mean because your weight's transferred over there. When you go over to the left side again, your right hand is gonna come down, up. You're gonna switch it, like you're gonna go back by putting all your weight on your right, and then you come back down, okay? So let's put that all together first. It's gonna go 5, 6, 7, hit, bass, 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 tap, 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 float, down, throw, down, left, right, hit, center, cook, left, right, cook, left, down, up, down, okay? Moving on from here, you're gonna milli rock, but it's gonna be a little different than what you normally do. When you milli rock, you kind of like do it down here. A lot of people will be up here also. The movement's gonna be a little slower just so it fits more with the music. From here, it's gonna go swing twice, 1, 2, on your weights on your right side. You're gonna swing on 3 because you'll hear a snare. So go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Another thing that you also gonna wanna do when you do those is make sure that you transfer the weight from your right to your left. It's gonna swing 1, 2, 3, you wanna step with it, and then 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay? You want to make sure you do that so because when you go into the next movement, it'll be easier. Let's add that from the top real quick. So then go 5, 6, 7, hit, bass, 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 tap, 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 funk, down, throw, down, left, right, hit, center, right, left, right, up, down. We go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, hit. If you didn't already know, if you haven't taken dance classes before, dance is broken into all dance is broken down into counts of 8. And all music is broken down into counts of 8. Well, especially all music that you can hear on the radio. So, anytime a dancer or a teacher or a choreographer will count you in, it's 5, 6, 7, 8, and that's when you start. And then it's also helpful to know when your moves are according to the counts and to the music. So I'll talk more about that later. But to go along with the choreography is after you just went 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. From here, since all your weight's on your right, you want to transfer to your left. You're going to go back into that sitting, but this time you're going to bring both hands to the air. It's going to swing. You're going to transfer your weight down up. So let's go hit, 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 hit. Okay, you just sway. Your body weight is going to be opposite of where your position where your hands are, okay? My hands are left, my weight is right. So from here, 6, 7, 8 is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Moving on, since all your weight's on your right side, you want to continue it on that right side with your leg, left leg's going to cross over and your right hand's going to point. If I remember, the move is called a ski-do, and it looks like this, okay? It's just hopping in place. Hop, hop. Then you're going to hop to the other side. Switch, hop, hop. Okay? We'll just add that. 6, 7, 8, oh, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, okay? So it's just hopping. You're pointing at the same side that left that you're... foot's going two. Okay? Try one more time. 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. From here, since all your weight's on the left, you want to transfer it to your right. You're going to cabbage patch. You're going to sit into the movement, step right again, bring your arms to the right, both fists, bring it around, step out with the left, bring it to center. And then you're going to go back a bit. Step right again, step back with the right, arms come around, step back with the left, to center. Okay? Let's go with the ski do. 6, 7, 8, oh, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. From here, using your, since your weight is centered, you're going to bring it to the right. Your right hand's gonna come up, it's gonna hit 1, 2, and go left. So my weight transfers from my right to my left, my right hand comes across my body, going to the left side, or my left side, the audience is right side. Here, okay? So I'm gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And realize that I'm pointing my toe, not necessarily pointing it, but making sure there's weight on the ball of my foot. So it keeps me balanced. Let's go from just here real quick, and then we'll move on. 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right, left, right, left. From here, since you're in this position, your left hand is just gonna come up, kind of just raises. Back to that right hand, and then imagine like there's a ball or whatever right here on my left hand side. You're gonna take that and just kind of like dribble it behind your back. You step with that right, down, right, down, left, down, right, down, left. Okay. If you want to add a little extra, what I normally do is I just rotate my wrist. It just adds like a little flair. You can do whatever you want. You can just keep it like this, but I don't know. I rotate my